The center of the spirit.
Can you now explain to me where this spirit is located in the human person? Does it have any particular dwelling place within the human body? How does it relate to the human organs and nervous system? What is the center of the spirit?
To clarify the center of the spirit, God says in the Holy Quran, Fortress 114, An-Nas, oblivious mankind, oblivious jinnkind, verse 1 to 6. Say, I seek refuge in the provider of mankind, the king of mankind, God of mankind, from the evil of the sneaking whisperer, who whispers evil in the chests of mankind, of jinns and mankind. In another fortress, number 27 of the Holy Quran, An-Naml, the ants, verse 74, he says, And verily, your provider knows all what their chests hide, as well as all that they reveal. And he, glory to him, says in the Holy Quran, Fortress 3, Al-Imran, the family of Imran, verse 29. Say, whether you hide what is in your chests or reveal it, Allah is aware of it. The spirit spreads through the nerves, and when the nerves are anesthetized, the spirit retreats from the place of the anesthesia, so that the patient does not feel any pain, even if one of his limbs is amputated, because of the spirit's escape from the anesthetized place. God says in the Holy Quran, verse 39, Az-Zumar, the groups, verse 42. It is Allah who takes back the spirits when dead, and those who have not died during their sleep. He takes back those on whom he has passed the decree of death, but he sends the rest for an appointed term. The spirit of the patient leaves his body because of the anesthesia, and the spirit of the sleeper leaves the body too, because of the sleep, and a ray of light remains in supervision over the body. The soul remains in the body which moves, and the heart pulses, but he does not hear, understand, or see anything. We go back to the women who cut their hand in the story of Yusuf, Joseph, the prophet. In the Holy Quran, Fortress 12, Yusuf, Joseph, verse 31, God says, When she heard of their cunning, their malicious talk, she sent for them and prepared a banquet. She gave each of them a knife and said to Joseph, Come out before them. When they saw him, they did glorify him, and in their amazement cut their hands, and they said, God is blameless. No mortal is this. This is none but a pure, noble angel. The women cut their hands because their souls were shocked when they saw Joseph's beauty. In this case, the spirits left their bodies and headed for the prophet Joseph. So they cut their hands without feeling any pain, because they were amazed at the sight of his beauty and were oblivious to all pain.
I truly never expected that my question about the spirit would be answered in such a clear and direct manner. From your answer, it is clear that you have long ago arrived at a final understanding of the issues with which I have been struggling for so long. Your examples and references to the Holy Quran have enhanced my understanding greatly. I already feel greatly indebted to you for your help up to this point. Allah, Allah, Allah.